The work I'm going to talk about today is a transcriptomics study of microglia. So we look at each individual cell and we see the set of genes that they've turned on. And from that, we can get a little snapshot of what they're actively doing right at that moment. So when I'm looking at this picture, every dot in this picture is one individual cell, and the location and the color of the dot tell me a little bit about what that cell is doing right then. And the arrows are calculations that say, if we were to make a prediction of what state this cell will be in a few hours, what will it be doing? So for example, there are arrows from this purple cluster up here to this green cluster over here. And I know that the purple cluster is a group of microglia that look like they are responding to a virus, even though there's no virus around. And the green cells are cells that have already eaten another neuron. So what it looks like it's happening is a microglia is responding to these antiviral signals and then using those as instructions to go eat a neuron. And that's why you see this pathway from these viral response microglia that really don't see any virus at all to this group of microglia that seems to have a bunch of neuronal material in it, but we think it's because they actually ate them. And this picture beside it, you can actually see some imaging of microglia in green that have eaten cells. So the cell nuclei are labeled in blue, and all the little red and white dots are actually bits of RNA that tell us that these nuclei are actually from neurons because they're mRNA that code for proteins that are specifically made by neurons. And you can see from this picture, especially the one on the left is one of my favorites. It looks like a little Pac-Man and it's eating a nucleus that's completely covered in these neuronal mRNAs. The cool thing about transcriptomics is you can go in with a question of what is going on here, and you can come out with specifics. Whereas a lot of other really cool biology, you have to know exactly what you're looking for before you start. But with transcriptomics, as long as you have a really good manipulation where you know you're going to change something, you can actually go in with a kind of open mind and just see what comes out of it and come up with new hypotheses that you can then test in different ways.